Welcome. Once again, we're excited to gather today to acknowledge another great class of athletes and coaches to our Gomery Athletic Hall of Fame. It's hard to believe, but we're in our 10th year, and actually would have been 11th as last year we were not allowed to do it. But in our 10th year of Athletic Hall of Fame, we're very excited to be here. For those of you that I have not met, I'm Bill Lechner. I am retired a couple of years out of being the activities director and just coach hockey now, so different world. But I'm honored and privileged that they allow me to still do this, so thank you. With that said, it's an honor and pleasure to be able to stand before you, such a distinguished group, so responsible for the rich traditions of Hill, Archbishop Murray, and Gomery School. At this time, Melissa Dan, our new president, was going to speak. She texted Judy and said she's not feeling well, so we will pass that, but she passes on her congratulations to the six inductees, and hopefully down the road we'll be able to talk to you, communicate, and you'll get to know her. She's in her first full year now as our new president. Usually I'd have time there to get ready before I switch. Look a little more professional. On behalf of Hill Murray School, I'd like to first welcome and acknowledge our past inductees. If we could have one applause at the end, and a lot of you were able to come tonight today, and it's great having you. And I'll just go in order from the most current class to the inaugural class. So from 2018, we have John Caldwell from 1974 and Tom Faust from 1983. If you'll stand and stay standing, please. From the 2017 inducted class, Steve Romanchuk and Kirk Wachler from 67 and 70. On 2016 class, Tom Kinsella from 1962, John Heller 1964, and Barry Frisby 1971. And is George there? George, get your phone. Okay, George. 1988. 2015 class, Andy Frisby from 1996 and Jim Wolf from 1964. From our 2014 class, Bob Young 1971. From our 2013 class, Andre Ballou and Tom Hillman from 1986. And Andre obviously is a teacher and a coach, well known. And then in 2012, Bill Wolf from 1968. And our inaugural class in 2011, when we first organized and got this going, Brother Francis Carr, the athletic director and everything, uniform washer, babysat all of us, all that thing. And Terry Scott, obviously a well-known and successful coach and teacher at Hill Murray and Hill. So that's our group that are here today that have inducted. Selection committee. Erin Herman, who a lot of you know, just retired, just talked to her before, and she's getting used to things. So in a different world, going from 100 miles an hour, 7 days a week, to being able to relax a little bit. And if you see a really kind of cool Chevrolet Malibu out there, she found her passion and drives a really cool old car. Erin's here, and retired principal. She is staying on as our girls basketball coach. Judy Hilo Schwartz, who does everything for us in the back. Judy, you need a... Class of 1979, and she's the alumni relations director. And probably very tired right now. She's been doing everything and trying to make it homecoming football, a lot of activities and craziness. But she's always going with a smile, and she's great. So thank you. John Heller, class of 1964. And the 2016 Athletic Hall of Fame, as I mentioned, is on the committee. And John Cole, John's in the back corner. John is a new activities director, been here a couple of years. With the COVID world was kind of, it was like, thank you, John, for letting me get away, and you good luck to you. does a great job and is our current activities director. And then myself. We'd also like to welcome our Hill Murray community of students, alumni, friends, and families that are in attendance today. What's really cool, and I know there's a lot of special places, but this is truly special, is it just seems the community of Hill Murray. There's so many connections. And even when you're gone for a long time, 5, 10, 20 years, and you come back, I just, it's amazing how I sit back there, the first hour before we get started on this, and see the bonding and see like it just takes off. And somebody knows somebody and relatives of somebody and friends of friends. So it's really cool. It is a special place. I've been in a few other places down the road through the years as a coach, and this is a special place. So congratulations to all you guys. Also, a real special recognition, and he doesn't know we're going to say it, but Brother Arnold, could you stand up? For those, I know most of you know him, but Brother is Mr. Everything for us at Del Marie, and he's got the hugest heart, and probably a lot of miles on your car, a lot of oil changes for traveling everywhere and going to everybody's event. So thank you, Brother, for being here.
Thank you.
Yeah. Last but not least, welcome to the teachers, administrators, coaches, both past and present. So I think we got most everybody covered, and we'll get to the reason we're here today. Oh, and by the way, before we start, and I was talking to a few people, and I know you're in those of you that are still working in the real world, lead times are a little bit of a challenge with product, as you guys know. And not to go, it's a positive day, so we're not going down that road. But I promise you that between Judy, myself, and the Marine staff, we have the plaques ordered. You know where this is going. We had everything done in June, gave it like we always do, plenty in advance. And we got a call that the product is not quite ready. But I promise you, we pay our bills, we have a good budget. The really nice plaque as an individual, for those who don't know, we each get a nice individual plaque. And then after, I'm very willing to show, or we will show, or John's around, we can show, up by in the athletic area, huge plaques on the wall from the different years that you will be on there forever to show your kids, grandkids, and everybody, friends and relatives. So if anybody would like to see the facility, if you haven't been around a long time, stadium, field house, whatever, we gladly do that. It's a lot of you haven't been back since then, and it's gorgeous, and the support of all you guys is outstanding. So, with that said, we will shake and do a picture with a pretend plaque, but it's humble. Our first inductee, 1968 graduate of Hill High School, 3 years varsity letter winner in baseball, 1 year all-conference. Honorable mention, 2 years all-conference. 3 years varsity letter winner in hockey, 1 year all-conference. Honorable mention, 2 years all-conference. Senior year all-tournament. Member of the National Honor Society. Member of the inaugural Minnesota Mankato State hockey team. Member of the Minnesota Mankato State baseball team, multiple awards. And the one, luckily, was 3 years older than myself, so I didn't have to face him. He went 54 innings without giving up a run. Minnesota Man of Mankato State Athletic Hall of Fame 2006 inductee, Greg Longeman.
This is the toughest part of the day. First of all, thank you, Bill. He called me and told me, and it was just a big surprise, and I was very Judy, we're Judy Schwartz. Thank you for all that she's done to get me up here today. By the way, I live in Atlanta, so it's a little hard logistically doing all this. When I heard this making the Hall of Fame, I talked to my friends down in Atlanta, and I said I was going to be in the Hall of Fame in my high school. And the first thing they said is, we want to be there. They're here. Set him straight.
fake.
He just doesn't know. But I'd also like to recognize some of my friends that I grew up with. Rick DeHeidel. I met Rick DeHeidel when I was a peewee, playing peewee baseball football at Hayden Heights. Rick, by the way, kicked field goals and extra points at that time. Since then, we've been teammates and line mates at Hira Hill probably for, you know, the whole time I was here. Larry Griesgrabber, I met him at Hazel Park Playground, and he's been a teammate and a friend for all these years as well. And thank you, Larry, for being here. Bruce Bursby, thanks for being here as well. We're lifelong friends. The most distinguished was we at Blessed Sacrament beat St. Peter's for the City of St. Paul Championship in grade school baseball. And Blessed Sacrament went on to win the Twin City Championship, which was a very good thing for me. I enjoyed that immensely. Thanks, guys. I met Steve Romanchuk in grade school. And he's been a friend, a competitor. We oftentimes competed for the same position. And I've been telling him for all these years that he kept blocking me as a shortstop. And he did. And then he'd move on, he's a year older, and then I get my shot, and then I can't be killed. Fortunately, there's a couple extra forward positions, so he didn't block me at forward, so we did well. The Romanchuk family, thank you for being here. Betty, this is Romanchuk. It's great to see you after all these years. Special family. Forgive me, this is the easiest way for me to do this. Now I'm going down. God bless Mommy, Daddy, Billy, Grady, Chrissy, David, Scott, Leanne, Jeff, and Pat. My brothers and sisters. Thank you. Squad. John Bolin, the Idol and I were all together then, and then we got together with Romichuk in the varsity. We played for John Bolin, and then the dynasty started. Andre Ballou, he came to Hill and started dynasty. He always said he wished we could have played for him longer. We would have been better hockey players if we had. But he brought to us colorful, long, speeches. We had never heard those before like that. And he taught us how to dump and chase. I think we had practices without pucks. How can you do that? But we skated a lot. And Rick and I were line mates. Steve, of course, for a while. Then when we were seniors, the call of Andre to allow a freshman to play on our line. He put Bobby Young between Rick and I. You know, what a mistake that was. One of the greatest athletes coming out. It was, I think, Les Larson was around, and Madden, Pat Conroy. So you could tell that the momentum was building for Hill Hockey. We kind of gave it a little spark. So that was it. I would like to mention, though, I'm remembering what I should have really said. When I was 5 years old, my dad built the skating rink. We took the kitchen chairs, pushed them around for a few hours, and learned to skate. He lit a fire. It was still every day. And as you can see from some of my brothers, David, of course, and everyone else, Scott was an excellent defenseman and hockey player at Hill. Drafted at the University of Minnesota. 15 years we had a lineup in hockey at Hill. And we started with my dad. He also brought me down to Pee Wee Baseball at Hayden Heights. And it lit another fire. And still to this day, I love to compete playing softball. Broke my leg 5 years ago playing softball. So I'm rambling a little bit. I don't want to do it. My mom must have saw hundreds and hundreds of games. She attended hundreds and hundreds of games. She rarely watched. Whenever her boys were pitching or playing on the ice, she rarely watched. My mom and dad provided everything. They were everything. So, I played hockey, played a little bit of football at Hill, and then played baseball. Freshman year, Bob Sullivan invited me to attend varsity baseball spring practice. He had no intention of me playing on the team, but he just wanted to see me what's going on. Billy Platt was playing shortstop, another guy. Greatest athlete in history, nice. I was playing shortstop. But he eventually went down to B squad. Mike Anderson was the coach. I was again blocked by Romichuk at shortstop. So they made me a pitcher. And I never played another position again after that day. I was a pitcher from that point forward in high school and college, and had a good career. And yes, it's true, I did hit Harvey Kill through a batting practice. I had one summer I did batting practice for the Twins. So, Johnny Mauer, the master, was our coach, John Jr. here. Let me just also reiterate, my catcher, Mike Benelli from Busted Saturday, John Manke from Busted Saturday, Mike Junker from Hill, Jimmy Morelli, and John Mauer, my catchers in high school. Jimmy was the backup to John. John was the, and Jimmy caught me at Hazel Park, and I'm not going to tell his story. Just ask him sometime about when I was pitching him at Hazel Park. But John Mauer, Sr., was respected. He was dearly. He was the best baseball coach I ever had. And he started something here at Hill also that I was glad to be part of. We learned some great lessons from him. I know many of you heard them, but you know, the game was in your attention span was waning or something, you know, and I fell to the ground, and I threw it towards first base. Should have never thrown the ball. And you know what's coming. Mr. Maurer came out to the mound. John Jr. was right with him, laughing, I think. And he knew what was coming also. And he said, Mr. Linesman, what are you doing? And I said, Mr. Maurer, I thought I was going to throw the ball over there and Larry would catch it. And he said, there you go, thinking again. Every time you think, you're going to lift the ball. And you know the rest of it. That you're the big John. And Larry, if you had caught that ball, I would have never had that life lesson. I want to say special hello to Brother Arnold and Brother Francis, who were at Yale from the very beginning of the years I was there. So, I know I'm forgetting things, but let me just close with this. I used to have, my bookends were battle at my first day of school and losing the state championship in baseball. But today, I have a new bookend.
Fred doesn't know this, but his brother David, who is in our Hall of Fame, was not able to make it, but he, at 5:30 this morning, asked if I would read this. Congratulations, brother, on your induction into the Hill High School and Hill Murray Hall of Fame. It's well deserved. I can remember you graduated in 1968, and I started at Hill in 1968. Your presence was still felt well after you left school. Many of the players I played hockey and baseball with also played with you. They spoke very highly of your accomplishments and your athletic ability. I had big shoes to follow after you left. I spent many seasons watching you at Hazel Park Playground and at Hill High School. Watching you over the many years showed me a path that I wanted to take in sports. You were a good example of the path I wanted to take at Hill High School. I have fond memories of you playing. These two stick out most of my memories. It was at Hazel Park Playground when you pitched against Dave Winfield. Those you guys know he's quite a ball player that retired from not bad. I got one hit out about 20 times against him and was very lucky. He's good. Anyway, you beat him 1-0. The hillside was packed with people and it was a classic matchup that was talked about for many years. I saw Dave in New York when he was with the Yankees and I was with the Islanders. We got talking and he asked if Ray was my brother. I said he was and he remembered that game. He spoke very highly of your pitching ability. Also, another memory was when you, that sticks out in my mind is when I watched the hockey game when Mike Melanger from Benilde put a hit on you and you did not get up. Now, this is a brother talking, and I remember crying, you were hurt, but you got up and continued to play on. I guess I learned a big lesson from that hit. Now, you think right now, I'm reading it, oh, he got up and that's great inspiration. No. I'd rather play more like Melanger than you. Seriously, Greg, you paved the way for me at Hill High School, and it's an honor to be the first brothers to be inducted into the Hill High School Hill Murray Hall of Fame. Enjoy the day, and you should feel proud of your accomplishments. Your brother. Our next inductee, a 1971 graduate of Hill High School, teacher, coach, Hill Murray School 1978 to 2010, taught American history and government, and snuck out to Phi Ed classes a real lot. Head football coach, 1998 to 2010, assistant football coach, 1979 to 1997, and 2011 to 2014. 6 years head boys basketball coach, 3 years head girls and boys golf coach. Boys assistant golf coach, 1979 to 1981. Assistant girls basketball coach, 1978 to 1981, and 1989 to 1990. Vince Conway.
congratulate my fellow inductees today. My accomplishments pale in comparison to you. Congratulations, Matthew, Tessa, Paul, Greg, and Rodney. Enjoy this special day. It's great to see Rod and join him. I've known him since he was a freshman at Hill Murray. He played JV hockey with my brother. And he's been a great friend all these years since. Thank you so much for your friendship. Get to know the family. What a great family, Mr. Romanchuk. Steve, it's wonderful. I'm humbled and honored to be receiving this. Words cannot express my gratitude, and I have a number of thank yous to those who made a great impact in my career and life. I wouldn't be standing here if not for all the people that affected me through the course of my career. First is my family. You know, in all the years that I did football banquets, family was always the last one that I ever mentioned, and I thought, you know what, I'm going to mention my family first. With regard to my family, I have a big thank you to Brother Francis and Bill Wold for hiring me as the B Squad girls basketball coach my first year in 1978. One of the girls I coached was Colleen Grassby. And if I hadn't coached her that year, I wouldn't have met her sister, Patty. And 2 years later, we were married. And we've been married for 41 years. We've had three awesome kids, Jen, Bill, and Brian, and seven wonderful grandkids. I'm pretty lucky I got that job. Thanks, guys. Patty's always been my rock. I'd like to thank my three kids, all Hill Murray alums. My daughter Jen was in theater, and she learned teamwork, hard work, commitment, and was a great big sister to her little brothers. I had the honor of coaching my sons in football, Bill and Brian. I had so much fun coaching them. Those years flew by. It was great to see them grow, to see all three kids grow. Jen into a great young woman, and Bill and Brian into great young men. They and their spouses, Brian and Jen, Bill and Chandler, Brian and Liz, have been wonderful parents to their seven kids. I'd like to thank Steve Fricke for giving me a kid who played 1 year of football in high school, sophomore year, the opportunity to coach high school football and allowing me to serve as his assistant for 19 years. He showed me the way and he gave me an opportunity to succeed as head football coach. I'd like to thank Brother Francis for hiring me, a pup, as the head boys basketball coach and the head boys and girls golf coach. Your faith in me gave me the confidence that I could do those jobs. I'd like to thank Aaron Herman. He hired me to be the head football coach at Hill Murray and stood through me through the first couple of years, which weren't real pretty. Thanks for giving me that opportunity. I'd like to thank Bill Lechner, good friend. We were a couple of mischievous lads. And we had quite fun in the early years. As AD, you stood behind me the last 11 years that I was the head coach and always gave me what we needed to make our program successful. I'd like to thank all the coaches that I worked with during the years that are all Hall of Famers.
gamers in their own right. Terry Skrypek, Steve Romanchuk, John Mauer, Tim Ryan, Ruth Sin, Dick Gazzoni, my little brother Jeff Conway, couldn't be here today, Barry Persby, and Ron Adams. They had nothing to gain by giving me their insight and their expertise, yet they were willingly gave me everything they could to help me. I'd like to thank the assistant coaches that I had in the 13 years I was head coach. They made so many sacrifices in order for our program to be successful. They were selfless, they put the program first, they had a great work ethic, and they made us better because of the gifts and experiences that they brought every day to practices, films, weight room, and game day. Several coaches were Hill Marie alums or parents. We worked outside the building and took vacation days or left work early to be at practices and games. A couple of those guys are here today. Steve Sitchi and Mike Sante, they represented the best of what Hill Marie is all about. They gave unconditionally to make Hill Marie better. Last but definitely not least, I would like to thank student athletes that I coached. An awesome collection of dedicated players who were committed to the team and gave everything they had to make the team successful. They worked hard in the classroom, they stayed out of trouble, and they provided volunteer service to the community. You were why I coached at Hill Marie so many years. Coaching was a great opportunity for me, a non-athlete. I was willing to learn and work hard. It was a way for me to instill in kids values, hard work, high character, teamwork, and a chance to be something bigger than themselves. Values that led to team and individual success on the field and in their lives. It was a tremendous honor to coach at Hill Marie for 36 years. My hope in coaching was that players who played for me would have the same love of the game that I had, and look back on the years that they played with great memories. I am humbled to be inducted into the Hill Marie Athletic Hall of Fame. Thank you.
First state tournament appearance for that sport at Hill Marie. 3 years varsity letter winner in hockey, senior year captain, all conference, all state, scored 54 goals his senior year. Do you have any eligibility left? first Hill Marie team to play in the all schools meeting private, public, everybody, tournament, public and private. 3 years varsity letter winner in baseball, attended the University of Wisconsin-Madison, and played hockey 4 years. Ron Romanchuk.
Obviously, I want to congratulate the winners of this year, Greg and Vince, Paul, Tessa, Bethany. Congratulations. Also, I'd like to recognize those previous inductees who are here today. It's all I can say is it's great to be part of this exclusive club. So, thank you very much and congratulations. This is where we get a little bit redundant here, okay? But today's special for a lot of different reasons, but when I found out that Greg Monson and Vince Conway were going to be inducted, that added some significance to this event. I've known personally these guys and their families for 50 years. So So Greg Lonsdale, my brother Steve, his brothers David, Scott, and Jeff, Eastside was with the Blessed Sacrament, played baseball, football, and hockey at Hazel Park, and they obviously played hockey and baseball together here at Hill High School. I remember at the Longevins, remember Greg, I'm not sure, the lot that you had in the garage. We'd sleep overs at night, sometimes Mom, we would sneak out at night, walk around late at night, and also remember shooting pucks and hitting baseballs in the backstop that you had beside your house. Those are really good memories. And Vince and his three brothers are some of my very best friends that remain that way today. Dating back, like Vince, I gotta call him Muzz because he's got 34 nicknames. So, so anyway, I've known Vince since eighth grade. And, Vince, who would have thought that, 40 years ago, we'd be inducted at Hill Murray Hall of Fame, much less on the same day. It's quite incredible. So, great story there, heartfelt. Also want to thank Judy Hyla Schwartz, special events extraordinaire, for planning this weekend. Seems to be going off without a hitch. It was an awesome Friday night, and I've been to a Hill Murray football game. For the record, I live in California. We've lived there for like the last 25 years, so I've got an excuse for not going to a football game. Although I do make it to a couple hockey games. Thanks for playing. It's been great. And also, the Friday night atmosphere, it was like a college football game. No, not like Madison, but but anyway, thanks to Melissa and Johnny Cole and to Billy Lechter for your support. For putting this event on this whole weekend and all that you do for Hill Murray Athletics. I also want to recognize my family in attendance here today. My 92-year-old mom, Betty, feisty as ever. My brother, Steve, and his wife, Sue. The love of my life, Catherine, 34 years she's endeared with me, five kids, 34 years living most of which in crazy California. So that's a feat in itself. We can talk about that later if you want. But anyway, not with us today is my dad, the best women's hockey athlete in the family. And our sister Patty, who's a 1965 Archbishop Murray graduate. They left us too early, but they left huge footprints with their family and with those they crossed in their lives. It's unbelievable human beings. I've had a fulfilling and rewarding life. I can attribute this to two things in my formative years specifically. Exceptional family and upbringing, and Hill Murray. Let me talk about my family a little bit, my upbringing. We were raised by parents who were so unselfish and giving of themselves. They taught us some of the most important values in life, right? Respect, hard work, integrity, humility, and best of all, a Catholic foundation that's been my moral compass to this day. My mom is the most loving, unselfish person I've ever met. If there's a more giving person in the world, I'd like to meet that individual. Mom has been an inspiration. And then there's my brother, Steve. The mayor, as I like to call him. The guy knows everybody in St. Paul. I think, crazy. Much he knows everybody. But anyway, if there was a picture in a dictionary with next to the word role model, it would be Steve. Many times in my life, I faced a dilemma, and I asked myself, what would Steve do in this situation? And then there's our sister Susie, the consummate bubbly cheerleader, whether it was back in the early 1970s cheering on her Hill Murray Pioneers or supporting her family today, just a great human being. When our sister Patty died, it was hard, right? She was in her mid-30s and just a rough spot in her life. And Susie really was the glue that kept our family together, so thanks, Susie, for all you did for that. So now, by the way, thanks, family, for everything you did. Wouldn't be here, don't want to be all. So now on to the influences of Hill Murray. Now, let's start with some of the great teachers that many of us were fortunate to learn from. And I'm going to say this too for the record. I have no idea who's going to be here. These are just things from kind of, not from the hip, but as you obviously have to put some thought into what you're going to say here. But when Brother Arnold and dude, I'm gonna call you out. You're even here to hear it. That's awesome. So anyway, Brother Arnold, you know, I struggled with algebra, but you know, you stuck with me, you stuck with a bunch of people. So thank you. Brother Martin, who'd have thought that I would like the chemistry? It was one of my favorite classes in high school. And then Mrs. Fisher, all 4'8" of us, down there, right? And some might be surprised, but Coach Scribe, he was equally talented in the classroom as he was in the field. He was an awesome English teacher, and I loved the way he taught because he could tell stories, and that was a great way to learn rather than just, you know, driving on. But really, I could go on and talk about all the great different teachers that have, but I think you catch the drift. We're fortunate to have people that really care and passionate. And then Brother Francis, who was not a teacher, I don't think you're talking Brother Francis, but all he did was, when I saw him Friday night, I thought, this guy's humor, I could just walk around this guy all day. He's a walking cartoon. I just didn't try. So we were fortunate to have been led by some exceptional coaches. And I'm going to start with Father John, who was a Hillbury boys soccer coach in the mid-70s. He allowed me and a couple of other hockey guys to trial and actually make the team in our senior year. And I think he made the right call because we made it to the championship of the regional finals to go to state tournament. Now that might not seem like a big deal, but the year before that team won like 2 games. So I think Father John made the right call by allowing us to play on the team. I wanted to call out to Mark Lauser and Danny, more specifically, again, Susan here, didn't know that you're here, but they're here now, for leading capital practices in the summertime that kind of taught us how to play the sport very quickly. The most influential coach for me was Terry Sprockbeck. I had the honor of playing with the coach in baseball and hockey for 3 years. You know, his hockey record speaks for itself, right? We don't have to debate that. But he's also a hell of a baseball coach. I remember my junior year, we were playing this team called Creighton. And it was a regional playoff. It wasn't in a state tournament. It was just a regional playoff game. We had to play these guys. And we lost 4-2. And a guy named Paul Muller, I don't know if you ever heard of him, he had a 365 a grand slam in the first inning. We lost the game 4-2. Dude, we had some great baseball teams, but we could never beat Creighton. And then I think as a matter of fact, they may have had 4 or 5 guys that were drafted in that high school game. They were still loaded. But you fast forward 2 years later, in 1976, Scry and the Pioneers bring home the state championship. So had the chance to see Coach Scry this summer and get the opportunity to let him know the positive impact that he had on me. And I get the chance to say it now publicly to everyone. Coach, the impact they had on me and your players was profound. So thank you very much. Of course, Hillbury wouldn't be what it is without our teammates, classmates. To a certain extent, you know, I remember the practices and the classes and the games, the wins, the losses, but I really remember the fun times we had, and as a result of that, the lifelong friendships that we've been able to establish. I think back, and I've got some great memories, and I'm sure we already talked about the 88 memories from high school, so I just picked out one. And again, this was done before knowing who was here, but so my junior year, I played hockey with Mike Regan and Mark Sheik. We were on the same line. Sheiker and along with us, rest in peace, my man. But we were a good line, but we were always the second line. So Reeves gave us the name the Deuce. Okay, there you go, the number two number. So we were Matt. I said, Coach, you know we can play. Just give it a look up there. We can score some goals. And by Reeves and Sheiker, they would sit on the bench. And back then, we didn't have masks, right? So these guys would just sit there on the edge of the bench, and they'd just chirp it out. Coach, let the deuce loose. Let the deuce loose. And after a while, we'd go out and score a goal or two, and come back to the bench yelling, the deuce is loose. The deuce is loose. So just loud enough for the coach to hear us. And find them, hey, still play here, no matter the first line or second line. Anyway, there's so many teammates that I can call out. Clausey, Pat, Mike Regan, J. Damsack, Grothy, Jeff Whistler, Hurdle, Mike Jablonski, Dave Sifko, Gabriel, Hilo, Danny Warner, Jerry Cook, Reeving, Johnny Pierce, the list goes on and on, some names that just jumped out. What's really special about this is 46 years later, I'm in contact with a lot of these people to this day, and that's pretty special, very special. I have a final story that I think epitomizes what Gilmore is all about. I think that the information you glean from these speeches here, what makes Gilmore different is the people, right? So this past summer, I call up Reeves. Hey, Reeves, I'm coming in for the Rome Chuck Open Golf Tournament this summer. Let's get some of the boys together and play some golf. Kind of runs Indian Hills, right? So got a few tee times together. I said, you know, as a matter of fact, let's have a match against the 76 team, the 76 graduates, because these guys have been chirping us the last couple of years that they're better golfers than we are. Okay? So we set the match up, and I still think that the 76ers are a little mad at the 75, because there's a bunch of us that dated some of the girls in the 76 class, and I think we kind of cut in some of their dating options. So I sit well with the 76 guys. But anyway, so we play the match, and of course, the 75 dominate, right? And we go back into the bar, restaurant, and have a few beers. And the 76ers, they stuck around, and they played with us on the 19th hole and respected their elders by putting up with us. But then, aside from that, there's some other special guests. Billy Lechner showed up, and Scribe showed up, and it just made the afternoon a great day, just a fantastic day. Like sitting around talking, knocking down some beers, it was a great time, just a great afternoon. So the day's coming to an end, and it's typical Minnesota weather, beautiful summer day. All of a sudden at night, it starts raining like crazy. So I was getting ready to run to my car because it was raining cats and dogs. And it was like, all right, so I live in California, so we don't have much rain, so I'm not used to rain that much anymore. But anyway, I was getting the courage to go out to the car, and Reeves grabs my arm and says, hey, come here, Ron, I got a shortcut here. So we cut through the golf club and through the men's locker room, and Reeves goes down and grabs an umbrella. And he walks me to my car with the umbrella so I wouldn't get wet. I don't know, guys, but that small act of kindness, I mean, that's what we're about, right? Just, it had a pretty emotional effect on me, and I think, thinking, God, that's pretty cool. Anyways, thanks for keeping me driving, appreciate it. In conclusion, I send out heartfelt thanks to all my classmates, coaches, and teachers that made Hillbury experience so fun, rewarding, and one of the very best experiences of my life. I'm so proud to be part of the Hillbury family. Thank you very much.
Riding super respectfully, Reeves does that for all of us. But then he asks us to join the club. Our fourth recipient, 2011 graduate of Hill Murray School, four-year varsity letter winner in basketball, captain senior year. Four-year state participant, state runner-up junior and senior years, 3 years all-conference, all-state junior and senior years, and all-tournament teams. Minnesota Coaches Association and Associated Press first team selection, Miss Basketball finalist 2011. Senior All-Metro and Defensive Player of the Year. 4 years played basketball at the University of Iowa with multiple Big Ten awards. 2 years of professional basketball in Switzerland and France, Bethany Doolittle.
One sport athlete, so I wasn't as accomplished as these guys, but Yeah, it was just a great experience for me. I just remember a couple of the things from my career here is going undefeated my senior year, Cousins junior year, and then I won't talk about the championship game. And then I think we beat De La Salle, who was a undefeated team my junior year, to get to the state championship, and that was pretty special. Also, won't talk about that championship game. But I don't know, I met a lot of my best friends from Hilbury during those years. I think this is a testament to Hilbury's community of how many people have connections here and how many people have great memories from that time. And I don't think I would be up here today with a lot of the people in this room right now, so I kind of want to go through and thank a bunch of them. First of all, just Hilbury in general, I think it lays a really great foundation for student athletes and the students in general for athletics, academics, to be successful later on in their lives. I want to thank teammates that I had along the way here at Hilbury. I think things had to line up pretty fortunately to have the teams that we did here and the success that we did here. And I got pretty lucky to have one of the most dominant guards in the state on my team when I was here in Tuscan City. And then I also want to thank the coaches that I had along the way, Coach Herman and Doug and Steve and Benny and all the people who really were supportive of us as student athletes on the girls basketball team. They saw something in a newly 6'3 ninth grader that was just kind of awkward and lanky and kind of helped shape me into a decent basketball player. I'd like to thank my family. They're some of the most supportive people in my life. My parents are over there. My dad was kind of the guy who took me to almost every AAU tournament when I was growing up, maybe everyone. He was there all along the way in college and professional career as well. He also is kind of the one who just encouraged me to take basketball more seriously. I definitely wouldn't be here without that. My mom, if you guys don't know, she also went to Hilbury. She is kind of the pioneer of all pioneers. She was the first mom pioneer. Rebounding record at some point. I don't know if she's told anybody about that, but she doesn't let us forget it. And then she was just an incredible role model for me growing up, and obviously another testament to Hilbury's community and how special it is. And my siblings, Tessa and Lauren, both different Tessa, both went through the same girls basketball program here, so it's really special to have that kind of common bond with them. And my brother couldn't be here today, but he was somewhere around the city doing something. But he's awesome as well, just one of the best siblings that I could ask for. I just want to keep it a little bit more brief, but this is super special, and thank you guys all for coming here. Thank you to Judy, and thank you to Bill, and everybody else that helped put this event on. And I'm sure I'll talk to you, a lot of you outside after this, but thank you very much.
Fascinating, your mom's so shy, it surprises me. Our fifth inductee, 2012 graduate of Hilbury School, participant in volleyball, 6 years of basketball, 2007 to 2012, 3-year captain, holder of 16 individual records and 10 team records in basketball at Hilbury, 4-year All-State selection, 3 state tournament appearances, Miss Basketball finalist senior year, 4-year letter winner at the University of Wisconsin-Madison, Tessa Sitchie.
Time and the dedication. It's interesting because now at 27. to Justin Morris and Gerard Curry in my AAU days. Thank you to Denise and Steve Bates for pushing me to always be my best and showing me that tough love was exactly what I needed. And to Aaron Herman Hearns, thank you for showing me that I have value beyond basketball and what I can do on the court, for caring about me as a person and showing me what loyalty looks like in a coach and friend. And finally, to my family, simply put, I would not be here without you all. To my brother-in-law, Brad, thank you for coming. To my boyfriend, Nate, he has never seen me play a game of basketball, but he knows what happens when we play horse, so. That's all I'll say about that. So my dad, middle school and high school, he wrote a big whiteboard, two columns, a can control column and a can't control column. For example, things like injuries and the refs went into the can't control column, although that didn't stop me from challenging the refs at every turn. And things like, attitude, defensive intensity, rebounding, those are the things that went into the can control. From an early age, the Sitchy household operated on a model that our success would be as a result of the time and effort we put into everything we did. Athletics were the logical world for all of us because we loved it, but I am certain that if I chose another path, my parents would have supported me either way, and I believe that is the foundation of my success. I knew no matter how I performed, as long as I gave my best, that alone was all that was expected of me, and thus, that empowered me to want to be better. I want to thank my aunts and uncles, my aunt Lil, who is here today. Thank you for your unending support throughout all these years. My auntie Jen, who came, she's not here today, but she came to lots of my games throughout the years and dragged my poor cousin Thomas along with her. Thank you to my grandparents, Jim and Jane Ann, who also could be here today, but I can't thank them enough for the countless games they've attended. With 22 grandchildren, you would think they'd be stretched thin, but amazingly, I don't remember them missing really any games, with my papa keeping his own personal statistics book, just to make sure the score table was correct. For my grandparents, Sid and Elaine, who are no longer with us, their spirits have always been present and had an impression on the way I carry myself and the way I live my life. Lastly, thank you to my people. Mom, thank you for the notes. You knew how to reach me and communicate in the ways that I needed. Thank you for your steady presence and advice. I have never felt more capable of taking on anything when she's in my corner. Dad, thank you. My first and lifelong coach, the best I've ever had. You knew the buttons to push to get the absolute best out of me, and you knew what to say and how to say it. You're the best mentor and example of a father I could ever ask for, so thank you. To my brother, who is not here today, but as many of you might know, he was scrawny, a little kid, very lanky, but he was tough as nails. I trade all of us Sitchies might have, but I like to think his toughness brought out the best in me. He was my biggest cheerleader and competitor, and we are both better because of it. And finally, I feel sympathy for those who don't have or have never had a sister like Rochelle in their corner. She was always the net that I knew I could fall back into if I failed. She went through everything first. She was older. She took on all of the challenges in life and handled it with a grace that I never could. She's loyal, getting kicked out of my games because she's yelling at the refs, loyal. not a lot of love locks between Sitchie girls and but the best teammate I've ever had. Thank you for being my best friend. And thank you to the Homer community for this tremendous honor. You know, nothing has been more rewarding than performing for the people that I love. My goal was to always make those who knew me proud, and in this I hope I have succeeded. Thank you so much.
Nate, I heard you were a good athlete, so don't play money one-on-one. You lose. Last but not least,
six inductee, 1982 graduate of Gilmore High School, graduated as a valedictorian. One-year JV soccer, three-year letter winner in varsity cross-country, senior year captain. Placed second in conference senior year. State qualifier junior and senior years, placed fourth in the state meet, three-year letter winner on varsity track, senior year captain. State qualifier both junior and senior year in the two-mile event, member of the National Honor Society, Paul Thurman.
Freshman year, I didn't even think about running. And as I looked back at my time at Hill Murray and what this is all about, I came up with three lessons. And any day of the week, I could come up with three different lessons, but these are the three that I came up with for my time at Hill Murray. One, embrace who you are and celebrate who you are. Two, go the extra mile. And three, take care of one another along the way. So embrace who you are. So I didn't start out at cross country and track. I started out actually in soccer. And I thought running was like something that you do to get from one place to another, but not like an end in itself. And so I joined JV soccer and that didn't go so well. In fact, the part that I liked best about soccer was being able to run around, the field. And Coach Ryan was my coach that year, and I think he probably maybe felt the same way about soccer. He said, you know, I really wanted to be coaching running. So it was the next year that I took a leap into cross country. That really helped me to understand that do what you do and embrace what you really like and do it to the best of your ability. Secondly, go the extra mile. So we had this crazy coach, Mr. Ryan, who the first day of practice we showed up, and I think I had maybe run a mile in my life, and that was probably around the soccer field. But he said, we're going to do the 5 mile run today. And I said, and he didn't say, you guys have to do the 5 mile run, or nor did he say, gosh, if you guys can make it 5 miles, you know, kind of try. He just said, you're all going to do a 5 mile run. There was no doubt to that. There was no second guessing. It was just, what we did, and it's what Mr. Ryan expected of us, that we would be confident and that we could do it. There were some even crazier girls on the girls' team. I remember Peggy Saraceno and Ann Klein, and they actually would come to the boys' team after our cross-country and track practices, and they said to us, you know, it's not fair. This is not fair. Coach Ryan is not working the girls as hard as he is working the boys. So after practice, Peggy and Ann would ask us to, could you please just kind of go an extra 3 miles with us today and kind of push us at the end of practice? I don't know if Mr. Ryan even knew that. But we, we go up and we run a few extra miles. And I think it's really those extra steps and going that extra mile that really gets us to the finish line. Thirdly, take care of each other along the way. We all know that growing up isn't easy. There's lots of challenges. In high school, these days, it's probably more challenging than ever. When I look back at my high school days, they were just wonderful. I had challenges, yeah, but I was really embraced by a community of people who cared and who took care of one another. People who really called out the very best in us. So I mentioned my parents. My parents, in addition to raising 8 kids, as if that wasn't enough, they always found time to drag the track team and the cross country team and the theater crews, wherever we needed to go, they would be there. And not only was feeding 8 of us enough, but they would feed the whole track team and the whole cross country team, and we were just one big family. And that really taught me a lot. In his homily today, Father mentioned people that have gone before us and are inspirations and saints. And I'll mention a couple. My art teacher, Mary Rumbley, and Mary Rumbley, she was just amazing. And actually, I mean, you could go through all the faculty and this, but she was just amazing. She always found something positive in every student. You could bring up to her the crappiest piece of artwork, and she'd say, you know, I really like what you did with the shading over here. Or I can tell you really put effort into this. Keep going. Another inspiration, Mary Krennick. Her door was always open, and somehow she convinced me that I could sing. And I think my husband Will would beg to differ, and I suspect that I agree with him at this point in life. But she helped so many students find their own voice, even when that voice was off key. I mentioned Brother Martin Selner, who somehow found a way to make organic chemistry exciting to a bunch of high school seniors. And it may have had something to do with his gargling liquid nitrogen and during class. It sort of got us all on board. I don't know that he could do that. And of course, Brother Francis Carr. He was unflappable. He was fair. If there's anyone with a sense of humor, that's a dry sense of humor, it's Brother Francis Carr, and he's been an inspiration all these years. And I would also mention Tim Ryan. He always valued time with his family and his kids growing up, but he always invited us and his team members into his life and into his household. And I know that he spent many hours after school, weekends, taking care of his team. And that means a lot to us, Tim. Thank you. And last but not least, someone who I met many years later, my husband Bill. He's from Buffalo, New York, so I still have to explain to him that no, Crete and Darrow is different than Hillmurray High School. But somehow he's put up with this inflated ego and also these dark days that I have and days of self-doubt and pushing me forward. And for that, I love and appreciate him. So, in summary, I just want to say, it's just such an honor to be up here today. And every student that we encounter, every person that we encounter, is somebody who has their own Hall of Fame to be in. And if we can bring that out from each other,
conversation with most everybody here. A couple of others real quick. Chris Zupper and Jim Hansen. Jim just retired as our president this year in attendance. Thank you for coming. 1973, you're way younger. And then Chris Zupper in charge of our development. So I think that pretty much covers everybody. But in closing, thank you again. And we say it a lot, but it's well deserved. To Judy Hilo Schwartz, to Megan Hermes, to Bridget Huss, and to Elise Langenfeld for their support on all this, for coordinating today's events and many others. To Father Colombo, who was our presider today, thank you to him. To Chef Paul, where we're going next, and hopefully you guys are hungry and can hang around. To new staff, to Chef Paul and the staff from Flick Catering, that's who's taking care of us today, right next door in a second. Most importantly, a heartfelt congratulations to our six new inductees and their families. Well deserved. It's really cool to see all the connections and the history, but well deserved group. For those of you in the future who want to nominate, it goes on a website to Judy Hilo Schwartz. She gathers it all, and then our committee starts meeting in the spring, and we go through it again, and hopefully have another great class for next year. Thank you all in attendance today. Appreciate the long distance that a lot of you have had to travel. Very appreciative. I hope you had a great experience. And thank you for coming so much on behalf of Hillmarie School and to the past, present, and hopefully well into the future, all of you guys that will hopefully be around for a long time. With that said, you've heard enough from us. We should go eat. If they're waiting for us next door, we'll be around. If anybody would like a tour or want to see the facilities after, I'll hang out or we will. And that's it. So we're done. Thank you.